Now we shall discuss about sequential logic circuit. In sequential logic circuit, there is a memory element. Why it is used? Because the output of sequential logic circuit depends on the present input as well as also the past output. So let us see the block diagram of sequential logic circuit. Combination logic circuit, here it is input and here it is output, and there is a memory element. So here there is a memory element which is connected to the combinational logic circuit to form a feedback path, as the output of the sequential logic circuit depends on the present input as well as the past output. So what is this memory element? So memory element is a device which stores the binary information. And when the memory element stores one bit of binary information, means one bit, that is called the flip-flop or latches. Now we shall discuss about the different types of sequential logic circuit. So sequential logic circuits are of two types. One is synchronous sequential circuit and other is the asynchronous sequential logic circuit. So now what is synchronous logic circuit? The synchronous logic circuit is, it depends on the clock pulse. That means the clock pulse, it is a signal which consists two states, that means 0 and 1. This is a clock signal, and in the clock pulse, when there is a transition from 0 to 1, so this edge, it is called leading edge or a positive edge. That means there is a transition from 0 to 1. And when there is a transition from high to low, that is 1 to 0, here 1 to 0, then this edge is called trailing. Or negative edge. And the time during the transition of 0 to 1, then this time is called enable, and transition from 1 to 0, that means high to low, that is called the disable. In case of synchronous sequential logic circuit, the output is changes, the state is changes during the transition, either from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. So that circuits are called sequential logic circuits. And next is the asynchronous logic circuits. That means in asynchronous logic circuits, there is a no clock pulse, clock signals. And this asynchronous logic circuits, it is simply a combinational logic circuits with the feedback, that means with the memory element. The output of the asynchronous circuit is depend upon the order in which its input signals change, and the status can change at any instant of time. And the asynchronous circuit do not use clock pulses, and the change of the internal state occurs when there is a change in the input variable. And asynchronous circuit is similar to the combinational circuits with feedback. Next is, they are used when speed of operation is important. Now, latches or flip-flop. Latches and flip-flops are one of the building blocks of sequential logic circuits. And one latch can store one bit of information, that is either 0 or 1. And only the difference between this latch and flip-flop is that they're the method which is used to change the state. The output of latches are constantly affected by their inputs as long as the enable signal is asserted. And a latch do not have a clock signal, whereas a flip-flop always does. So latches means it is a memory element. It is a device which stores the one bit of information. Latches and flip-flops are similar, but the only difference is that the outputs are changes. The only difference is that the change of the state, that means in case of latches, the output is changes, that means it stores two states, either 1 or 0. One bit of information, that means a latches can store 1 or 0. And it is changes, the difference is that the output states changes. In case of latches, the output is changes when the input is changes. Once the enable is asserted, that means it is in the combinational logic circuit, that it is a latches. So this is the input output Q, suppose A. This Q is state is changes, that means in latches the output state is changes when A is changes, that is input is changes, as long as the enable is asserted. So that is the difference. But in case of flip-flop, the output change of the output states is depend on the clock. So that is the basic difference. Next we shall see the flip-flop. Or it simply it can be written as FF. So flip-flop is nothing but a memory element which can store one bit of information, and this flip-flop are generally are designed by using the NOR and NAND gates. So let us first check the RS latches circuit using NOR gate. So here R means it is expressed as reset, and S is set. So the logic circuit is for NOR gate, using NOR gate. This is a NOR gate, one input. This is another NOR gate. This is one input. So here R and other is the S. And as there is a memory element is there, that is a feedback part. So this output of first upper NOR gate is goes to the input of lower NOR gate. And similarly, the output of the lower NOR gate will go to the input of the upper NOR gate. So there are two outputs. In case of flip-flop, the two outputs are, one is Q and the other output is the complement of the first output. That means if Q is 0, the other output is will be 1, or if Q is 1, the other output will be 0. That means the two outputs are complement of each other. And if we see the truth table, suppose R, first is R, then S, one is Q, and that is Q bar. So these two are the inputs, and these are two are outputs. So first we see the two conditions 0 0, then 0 1, 1011. So first, for both the inputs, that is R equal to S equal to 0, then what will be the output? The output states Q will be 1 and Q will be 0, any one. So suppose we consider this Q is 1, that means this is the first condition, means 0 0, so Q may be 1 and Q may be 0. So it does not depends on the condition of the two inputs. The NOR gates, the output of the NOR gate does not depends on the condition of the two inputs, that is R and S. So the output of this combination, that is 0 0, there is no change, and see, that means if you write here comment, there is no change. And for the second case, when S is 1, that means S is 1 and R is 0, then what happened? This output S is 1, so Q bar output is 1 is S plus this Q. So if as we know from the rule of NOR gate, what we know, suppose 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, for OR gate what happened? 1 1 1, and this is for OR gate, and for NOR gate that is 1 0 0 0, just complement of the OR gate. So what we have seen, when any of the input is 1, the output is NOR gate output is 0. So as S is 1 in this case, so output will be 0. As Q bar is 0, that means Q is what? Q will be 1, because Q is the complement of Q bar. So for the second condition, Q is 1, Q bar is 0. That means it is a set output, because set, when S is 1, that means set input is 1, the output will be the 1. Next condition, third condition, what we have seen in the third condition, R is 1 and S equal to 0. So what will be the Q? Q is R plus Q bar. Q bar is the output of the lower NOR gate. So R is 1, that means definitely Q is 0, according to this rule of the NOR gate. So Q is 0 means Q is 0, therefore Q bar is 1. So for the fourth case, when S is 1 and R is 1, then what happened? Q will be 0, because Q is R plus Q bar. Okay, then similarly Q bar is also 0, because this S is 1, so any of the input is 1, output is 0. But this condition cannot be happen, because we know that Q is opposite of Q bar. That means if Q is 1, the other output is should be 0. But in this case, we have got both the 0. So this condition is called a race condition. That means it is not used. So it is called the race condition. So this we have discussed about the RS flip-flop or latch by using the NOR gate. So dear learner, in this video class, what we have learned, first we have discussed about the subtractor. So there are two types of subtractor. One is half subtractor and the other is full subtractor. And next we have discussed about sequential logic circuit. So there are two types of sequential logic circuit. One is synchronous and other is the asynchronous sequential circuit. And we have also discussed about the latches and the flip-flops. Then we have discussed about the RS latches, that means by using a NOR gate. In our next video class, you will get the other flip-flops like SR clocked flip-flop, JK flip-flop, master slave flip-flop. So these are all sequential logic circuits. So we shall meet again in the next class. Thank you all.